You might not think that a few simple words could make you crave McDonald's breakfast sandwiches. But if you listen closely to the sound of me saying McGriddles, McMuffin, you might be wrong. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Thank you for visiting ChristopherMedia.net. Christopher Media, let's make some noise. From Asthma Core Studios near Detroit, Michigan.
Oh, man.
It's the Weedsmen Podcast.
I have no idea what's going on.
And now...
You have smoked yourself retarded.
Here are the Weedsmen.
You want to get high?
Too late.
Yeah, way too late.
I was already sitting here. See, I had to look up to see... Is this Halloween show?
Yes.
This will be the last
Very
show
scary.
Before Halloween.
Ooh, yes, that's right. This is going
wow.
up next weekend.
Ooh.
But Halloween falls on a Monday, doesn't it?
Yes.
Yes. Yeah, that's next Monday.
Oh, wow.
And after
shit.
That.
So what are you dressed as, Chris?
The election. The scares don't stop at Halloween this year.
Oh, you get an extra week
yeah.
of shitting your pants. That shit's scary for real.
Yeah, that is scary.
Don't elect the guy who looks like a pumpkin.
That's what I was going to say. You'll throw out your pumpkins, but you'll still see his big orange face on TV.
Right.
I hope there's a payoff, and then November 7th, he calls her a cunt.
Yeah.
Just right before the end, he finally says it.
I'm going to beat that stupid cunt. That's what he's going to say, and it's going to be like, oh.
He already said, you are at a debate. Maybe he'll be the first person to have the word cunt in his concession speech.
Right.
No, he said nasty little woman.
That's
as close
as you're
going to get.
No, he's warming up.
He's just getting started.
I like that.
He's like, we'll throw out nasty little woman, and we'll kind of keep going from there. Test water.
I mean, you record him enough in his off time, you'll probably get a cunt here or there.
Right.
In reference directly to Hillary.
Oh, for sure. On Halloween, huh?
Yep.
Really?
Boom.
Yeah, you're right. No, thinking about
scared
it.
Man.
I mean, you guys got a costume
nah.
for any?
Oh, yeah, man. I'm rocking a full-on Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
Yeah.
We're all dressed up. Chris looks like Dracula.
Oh, that's
he's
right.
Fester.
That's right. Fester. Nobody knows.
Yeah, there we go. I couldn't
Chris
see.
Uncle Fester.
Well, I'm dressed as Cyclops.
Oh, nice. You got the orange hair.
As a leader
Scott
of
Summers.
The blue team.
Yep. It's the yellow and blue suit that Aaron's
yes.
sporting. Not the original.
Yep. I had to go out and find many belts.
You look good, man.
Yeah.
Mike, who you dressed as?
You find a yellow belt. There's
me.
I thought you were Deadpool.
No, I'm
Deadpool.
Yeah.
That's scary.
No, I ain't got shit to dress up for anything, really.
No, I have nothing to dress up for. I'll probably be spending sleeping.
Yeah.
I'm the scary stoner. I'm traveling on Halloween this year.
Ooh,
ooh, I'm out of weed. Scary!
Usually when you go to the dispensary, you'd be like, trick or treat.
I know, right?
Yeah. Maybe we'll get something this year.
Yeah, I'm flying into Portland, heading up to Tacoma, spending the week there.
Even my kids aren't interested, though.
Really?
Oh, already?
Yeah, already.
It's already there?
Wow.
10 and 13, and then I was like, so, what's up with Halloween? And they're like, what the fuck do you mean?
Yeah.
We get anything we want whenever we want it anyway, so
right.
why the fuck would you send us out in a disguise,
dude? I went out every
candy.
Halloween until like senior year of high school. I swear to God, because at some point it became about just getting a whole bunch of candy.
Yeah,
your teenage.
How is it not fun still,
man?
Yeah,
all the way.
I would
yeah.
do it right now. If
I think maybe my senior year I didn't, but I think yeah, up until my senior year.
Is this an excuse to get together with your friends, maybe smoke
Hell
when
yeah.
you're in high school, and then go out and get free candy?
I remember that freshman year.
Yeah, and then you'd eat it all the next day in school in first hour.
All day. Yeah. All day. My shit lasts me all day. I had long streets I went
to. Yeah, I see. We were straight edge. But we would still go out.
Trying to get that lace stuff. Oh.
Yeah.
We'd dress up. We'd party.
Nice.
I am going to try saying trick or treat at Spencer. See what the fuck happens.
There you go.
You never fucking know.
They might give you something good or...
Yeah.
They're smart. Like, they'd be giving out pre-rolls.
Here's an edible.
Oh, shit. An edible?
Oh,
like
yeah.
a pumpkin?
Well, that's yeah. Oregon. I'd have to go over the bridge. Oh, I'll be in Washington.
Yep.
See, Oregon, there's still limits on your fucking, on their crazy, their edibles. Supposedly the law's about to change from what I keep hearing.
Really? Good or bad?
They're not going to be, there's two things I've heard. I've heard they're going to go up to 50 milligrams or they're going to stay at 40. But the consistent thing I've heard is you're going to be able to buy more than one.
Really?
Right now, you can go into a dispensary in Oregon. You can get a edible, and it's 40 milligrams.
It's so, okay.
I mean, it's like smoking a couple joints.
Right.
But, you know, man, I don't know. Ever since I had that 275 milligram legal drink, that lemon ginger, everything
what
just
do they call
compare.
That? Like, is that like a beer? Or is it a like a tea? Or
no, it's a drink. It's a soft drink, really.
It's kind of like a soda.
Yeah, it's like a soda.
Okay.
It's carbonated.
Fuck your ass up, man.
Nice.
I mean, the 80 gram makes you feel nice, but I mean, I don't know, man. The 275. Oh, man.
Fuck your hype up.
Might there, be a little too much.
No way.
Are there in-between variants? You said 80 and 270?
Damn. Well, I accidentally got my hands on the medical version in Oregon
when
I initially had it.
That's right.
Yeah. That's right.
The strongest you can get recreationally, at least where I was, is Washington, you can get 80.
Damn.
You can get the bottle, which is 18, but in Oregon, nothing's over 40 milligrams.
I get you. I was thinking there was like a spectrum of them.
Right.
Well, in Washington, they do sell you. They'll sell you. In Washington, there is. You can get the 80 milligram or the 40 milligram, and then even like the, I think it's 25 milligram.
Damn.
That's right.
Yeah.
They call it the bunny slope.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's for guys like Mikey B.
Strawberry and peach. That's the flavor.
Well, yeah.
Sometimes you just...
Are you trying to make an excuse?
Sometimes it's not necessary.
Sometimes it's not.
With the election coming up and a lot of states voting on cannabis in various ways...
Prop 64. Come on, California. You're our second most downloaded state. Yep. We know you can hear us.
Yep.
Do the right thing. But, well, I heard it's like it's a crazy margin ahead anyway.
Sorry. Oh, that's good.
There's still going to be some votes in states like Oregon who are... still kind of fine-tuning their legal cannabis program.
Indeed.
What you were talking about is one of it, how they regulate on edibles and other things like that.
You get to be an adult soon in Oregon.
But nice. part of the initial measure that was passed actually gave an opt-out clause for local governments to
It's the same thing as Colorado. Down.
Yeah. That they could, if they got a majority in their county, was it county or just...
Well, I know in Colorado, it's just city.
Yeah, I think it's city.
It's city by city. Because in like Colorado Springs, they voted to opt out. But literally, like as soon as you leave the border of Colorado Springs, it's like all lined with dispensaries. So people live in Colorado Springs could still get their trees.
Right.
Because the mailing addresses technically are not in Colorado Springs. So once you were like in the suburb of Colorado Springs, it's, you know, it's game back on.
Right. Yeah, but now that they've seen that, you know, the other cities didn't burn down.
Yeah, I know, right?
A lot of them are changing their mind. It's
not kindergartners walking around with syringes falling out of their arms.
It seems to be
hopefully not.
Smacked out of their eyeballs.
I guess lifting the ban on it, not re-legalize. Lifting the ban, the local ban, has become a popular polling topic recently in Oregon, and it looks like you're gonna find it even more widespread.
Yeah, because I tell you what, there was one trip where I was out in eastern Oregon in a town called La Grande, and every dispensary in town was only medical.
Really?
Yeah. I mean, I stocked up in Portland before I went out there for the week, but when I was heading on my way back out to town, I was like, eh, let's see what they got to offer in La Grande.
Yeah.
Jack shit, unless you have a medical card.
Damn.
Because I even tried to be, they're like, hey, you got a medical card? Because I tried this too at the other dispensary when I tried to get my hands back on the full strength drink.
Yeah.
Hey, you got a medical card? Yeah, sure. And I handed my Michigan one, and they go, oh, you know, I'm playing the angle just to see if it works. Like, then they go, oh no, you're from another state. I'm like, oh, I was like, you don't take that? Like, no. I'm like, why not?
Yeah.
Like, it doesn't make it.
Why not?
Oh,
damn it.
Oh, Michigan doctors aren't good enough for
right.
you? Huh?
Well, yeah. Well, no, I mean, I'm just going to buy what I want recreationally anyways, but I mean, like, why doesn't my medical card work?
Well, you can't blame a business like that for protecting themselves from, no matter how weird the laws get, even in states where you have legal access to cannabis.
No, I understand what the business. I think it's more rhetorical. Why not?
No, I hear you. I know that you weren't like, you know, pissed off at them. Indignant.
I'm not buying cannabis here. No, I bought cannabis there.
Kick a hole in the display case and storm out.
Yeah. Well, no, except the ones in Le Grand. I could not buy cannabis.
But yeah, it just points out that, you know, even when it's legal, it's still fucked up.
Yeah.
It still doesn't make sense.
On a somewhat related note, you hear Iraq just voted to ban alcohol.
Yeah. Just now?
Today, Iraqi parliament voted to ban alcohol.
Really?
Damn.
Yes.
So
does that mean they're officially 100 years behind us? They're going to repeal it in 10 years like right. We did? Like,
I didn't know that they had access to alcohol.
Dude, it's not a third world country. I mean, part of it is, but no, well, there is civilization over there.
No,
regardless
of
what the news lets us see.
No, I mean legally.
Oh, yeah.
I thought it was legal already.
No. Well, it is now.
Yeah. Did they have bars and shit?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Well, it's because the scale is tipped in Iraq from Catholic to Muslim. That is the issue behind
Damn.
It.
Damn.
Mm-hmm.
The ban. That's for another podcast.
Yeah.
Right. Because you've had probably a lot of extremists from surrounding countries that have fled in there, too, because that's where...
That part of the world's popping right now.
Right.
Shit going down.
They want to be where the action is.
Yeah.
You know? Hey, when the Nazis were storming France, Captain America wasn't sitting, you know, at home listening to the radio. I was going to say watching TV.
I don't know what that means.
He wanted to get out there where the action was.
That's right.
I don't know what any of that just meant.
He just wanted to fight.
He was a terrorist. No. Yeah. Wait a minute. What were we talking about? Are you packing that bowl again? How dare you, sir?
I'm good.
How dare you?
I'm good. I'm good.
Good
tapping out.
Day, sir.
Good day. I say good day to you.
Well, shit, what else is going on? As of recording this tonight, well, somebody has probably already gotten their brains bashed out or in.
Right.
Or all over. Swirled around.
I've been kind of searching what? For it, so.
Don't. Are you going to
I'm not going to tell you. I won't
tell
you.
Oh, is this Walking Dead
yes,
stuff?
Yes.
I won't tell you. I'm just. I don't give a. No.
Yeah.
I'll find out soon enough.
Walking Dead is back today, and
that's the man right there. That's and all Negan, I care about.
Yeah. Do you care to make a prediction on who Negan, the character that we were introduced to in the last episode of last season, mm-hmm. but referenced all the way up until then? There's a lot of talk about, you know, Negan's going to take care of this shit, and we were left in suspense as to who is going to suffer, because he made it clear that in order to set an example and send a clear message, one of them would have to die, and it had to be at the hands of his bat wrapped in barbed wire named Lucille, because she was hungry.
Mm-hmm.
And she has to feed, so...
Yeah.
There's been many promos that have tried to lead us to believe it was one character or another.
Right.
Do you care to make a on-the-record prediction?
Before seeing it, I was picking Abraham or Glenn.
Man, those are two good ones. So, so Abraham's kind of he's a different one.
Yeah.
Abraham's a safe bet in that the show's not going to fall apart without him. You're not going to piss off a lot of people.
But he's still a heavy hitter, man. He's helped out that group a lot.
It'll hurt in the way that he has been with the group for so long now. Glenn has been there since the beginning.
Glenn's number one, man.
Right. Yeah, Glenn.
He saves Rick.
Yeah, Glenn gets Rick out of the shit.
Yeah.
And before Rick is a leader and...
Rick goes walking in there with a high horse with a bag full of shotguns and thinks he's going to take Atlanta in one night. In the first episode. It's like, Jesus, man.
Right.
That's one way to go in. But we all find out quite quickly. But yeah, I mean, Glenn, it sucks that... I mean, I love Glenn, the character. It's been good. So, I mean...
Well, the reason that Glenn isn't that far out... Well, one, we know that they have the capability to be heartless and rip characters away from us even when we are still enjoying them being around.
Right.
And But that's what happened in the comics. It's no right. spoiler to say that years ago.
Yeah, I'm not picking anything crazy out of the norm.
Right. Glenn perished at the hands of Negan.
Right.
And it went down exactly like that final scene did.
That's why.
But yeah. Robert Kirkman has been very explicit in that things in the show don't necessarily have to go the way they did in the comics, although there have been a lot of similarities. There's some thoughts about Rick losing a hand this season.
Mm-hmm.
Carl's already lost an eye.
It's been so crazy the last season. Now
so
we have this.
There's a lot of things that these are lining up with the way things happened in the comic books.
Mm-hmm.
But they know that they can't. Not only is it pointless to try and just retell that same story, it's a wasted opportunity. I mean, if you're a storyteller, then wouldn't you want to, like, you know, tell it in a different way? There had to have been points where you're in this story, you're thinking, I could go this way or that way. You know, if I go this way with the story, this is where it's going to end up. And if I go that way with it, it's going in a totally different direction.
Right.
And it seems like he has explored a lot of those roads with this series. And even with the Fear of the Walking Dead, it's like now with new characters, I can take an opportunity to tell completely different stories, different perspectives about this.
Right. It's, you know, they're good characters. I mean, it's just like watching TV. You know, you fall in love with the character and then you know, the person adds their own personality as an actor
right.
to that character.
It's really
makes
tough.
It that more interesting.
Yeah. As much as I do appreciate the writing and directing in that show, the actors are the ones who are far and away. I mean, without them, you wouldn't have the show
right.
the way that it is.
Exactly.
And, you know, maybe that's more hats off to the casting director as well.
Mm-hmm.
But still, when you change around those important pieces,
right.
you could risk losing people, if not just temporarily, sometimes permanently, when you remove a character from a show.
Right.
And you're also fucking with somebody's career, their livelihood.
Right.
Right? To
yeah.
say, like, hey, I know you've been enjoying your time on The Walking Dead for the last 4 years. But,
right. It's been a great check, right? Yeah.
Lucille's hungry, and yeah. if we don't give the audience some blood, like, and it's got to mean something to them. So, afraid you're up, buddy.
Yeah.
Listen, we're doing some flashbacks next season, so, you know, we'll be in touch.
We'll call you. Yeah. We'll call us. We'll call you.
He did the Monster Mash.
It was Halloween.
The first time I'm hearing this.
Oh, yeah.
I think of it as The Simpsons.
Yeah, me too.
You played the wrong record, didn't you? Why are you doing this to me?
Right.
What was it? Valentine's Day or something? Monsters in Love.
I love it when they do those asides. Like they do it with like a broadcasting team of some sort, usually, like whether it's in the booth at a sports announcers in the booth or on TV. I always do those little asides of, like, you know, one-liners that will reveal there's like a deeper relationship going on there. That was a hit song twice. There it is.
KBBL.
Monster Mash with you on this beautiful Valentine's Day.
It's Reverend.
Why did you play that song today? There must be thousands of love songs.
Well, it's kind of a love song. All the monsters enjoying each other's company, you know, dancing, holding their evil in check.
You got the wrong record, didn't you?
Why are you doing this to me?
Nice.
What are you doing? I can't believe people actually like that song.
Hey, man.
Like you said, it was a hit.
It was Graveyard Smash.
I don't know. I mean,
you know the words.
Yes.
Yeah, I
thought this was cool when I was like six.
Hey, dude, I don't care. I'm a big fan.
Wow.
Hey, sorry. I didn't grow out of certain things.
I have to admit that if I do happen across it on the radio, I will listen to the whole thing.
Right.
But that's only going to happen
piece of shit.
Once, maybe twice a year.
Yeah, not outside of it. I mean,
I can don't probably point. Think this song right now. Right. My 6-year-old nephew.
But
hey, Monster Mash is great.
You know,
he's 6.
Being still a hipster indie rocker, I'm more of a fan of the Crypt Kicker 5 stuff myself. And it's a graveyard smash. The other band that he references in the song.
Ah.
And talks about the Crypt Kicker 5.
Yeah.
He's kind of introducing the band. I forget which member is. Like, he's saying like he came in to play on guitar or whatever from his gig. And never mind. Mm.
What other Halloween songs are there, really? You have the Monster Mash and...
Thriller.
Well,
yeah, Thriller. The Ghostbuster theme song. They like to rock all the time.
There's 3 good ones right there.
Yeah.
No, well, 2 good ones in addition to the Monster Mash. But then you have, really any weird song.
Anything from Slayer.
Or Misfits.
This is not Thriller? Well, it's the beginning track.
Sometimes it's Pink Floyd. You know, sometimes it's just weird shit.
Right.
But
like Werewolves of London is a huge
one-eyed, one-eared, flying purple people eater.
Yeah, that's
one horned, sir.
Sorry,
one horned.
3. I don't know.
What did I say? One-eyed,
one-eared.
I bet you he has 1 ear too. Why would he have 2 ears?
Yeah.
I was singing the demo version recorded by the Crypt Kicker 5.
Oh wait, there's a remix version of this. Let's check this out.
Well, on the other hand, Thriller, I'll listen to the first verse and chorus, and then I'll probably change it.
Oh, I'll let it go. The bridge is fucking great. This is good.
Well,
this is Michael Jackson and Quincy Jones coming together, maybe with a U. I don't know about what went on studio.
But... A lot of drugs.
Yeah.
That's what I'm going to go with.
No, man, this song's great.
Hell yeah.
Oh, no, wait, that's right. I recently learned the entire band on this album is Toto.
Really?
Oh, that's right.
Yeah.
It totally makes sense, too. Yeah when what's his name was on the Adam Carolla show?
Steve Lukather.
Yeah. There is a story. This was on MaryJane.com.
I saw this last year.
Snoop's website.
What is it?
Snoop's.
It's Snoop's?
Who had a big birthday recently.
Who's Snoop or the website?
Snoop. Snoop's.
What, he turned 50?
56, I believe, was the number.
No. Snoop is not 56 years old.
Are you filtering that?
No, it's a remix.
Oh. Oh, Jesus,
I think it
Christ.
Was. I'll have to look.
There's a shitty techno mix.
A shitty techno mix of Thriller.
Okay, so what, the story they had. Just pot it down a little bit. Worst cannabis-inspired Halloween costumes. That one's just a pot leaf with a person's head.
Yeah.
But she does have, like, I don't know if that's just a...
Those are piercings.
She has a pierced nose, but it's maybe supposed to be a cannabis leaf. Looks like an upside-down crown.
Oh. Now, there we go.
Head nurse, get it? Yep. Do you have a nurse's outfit with a pot leaf?
Head nurse.
Oh.
Little accents on it. Head... I don't get it.
The head?
I don't know.
Good, head. Yeah.
You know, for heads. Oh, I get it. Hey, I think we have seen this one before. The baked potato.
That's fucking sweet. I'd wear that outfit.
So, there's a potato that looks cut open with butter on it. And then pot leaves placed over it instead of chives. Just clever touch.
I just make sure that joints are...
Some droopy eyes.
I'm fucking... Bless you. Oh, sorry. Gesundheit.
Although I feel the droopy eyes on the potato are redundant because your face is in the middle of the potato and
yeah.
You're going to be all droopy-eyed. Especially if that big-ass joint is real. Although that's probably a novelty. That's his, like as long as his arm.
So you could say you're the baked potato. It's your prop.
Oh, yeah.
Whoa. Here we go. Pot leaf. What does this mean?
I don't
this
care.
This is just a cat. This is a cat suit with pot leaf.
Perfect.
Logo on it.
I'm in.
Perfect.
I mean, I'm not saying that I'm mad, especially not with her wearing it.
Right.
Howdy.
Yeah, hello.
Weedman, and this looks is like a bubbles. Superman. It does look like Bubbles when he's a wrestler.
Yeah, green bastard.
Yeah, the green bastard. Kind of looks like a Ninja Turtle, too.
Yeah, he does.
Yeah, it's just a guy in a shitty superhero outfit with a cape and a weed logo on his chest and on his forehead.
Hmm. You make that at any fabric store?
That's not very imaginative. Roster Girl 420 Weed Flag.
So, that's a sweet dress. I can see some chick.
Yeah, how do you describe this? It's a dress flag. It's a flag dress, right? Boom. But that doesn't mean anything.
You take two flags, sew them together, put your body in there. That's what it looks like, basically.
If you took a girl's body as, like, the pole of the flag, almost, and her extended arm would be, like, holding out the flag.
Yeah.
So it looks like she could fly in it if she had one on the other side.
I was wrong and you were wrong.
Imagine how tragic that would be if she fell out of an airplane in that dress. And she'd have like the one. She'd be like, if I just flap the one arm fast enough.
I know, right?
At least
I
can
fly in circles until I hit the ground and maybe it'll break my fall.
You'd be so dizzy. Oh my god. If you could survive that. Whoa, look at that suit. I'd wear
joint
it in public.
Venture suit. So this is a power suit that is all weed print.
I'd wear
weed print tie. He's got some John Lennon glasses on, too.
Get rid of the glasses.
He looks more like a Batman villain.
Yeah, Weed Man.
Brownie Girl. So
Brownie
typical
girl.
Slutty Girl Scout outfit.
Yeah,
and it
not
says,
much to it.
And it says Brownie Girl, and there's a pot leaf on the sash and on her hat. The Grim Reaper.
Yes.
The Grim Reaper is a guy with a robe and dreadlocks and what looks like a sickle, except for where the blade would be, there's a very large, comically oversized joint.
Another thing that needs to be real weird.
And then we've got, what
Cheesy
would you call this guy?
Zach,
what, dreadlocks and a, and a jogging suit? Rastaman. Oh, this is the one where the only part of this costume is me appropriating somebody else's culture.
Exactly. Yeah, pretty much.
No actual joke here unless you just find Jamaican people funny.
Right. Jamaican be crazy.
Right. So, peace sign. John Lennon glasses with pot leaves painted over them. I hope you can't see shit. And what looks like the type of necklace that you would get at Mardi Gras, but the beads, and there's big beads that are pot leaves.
I like the quote under there.
THC Cheerleader. Boy. Oh, wait a minute. Why didn't the image not load for THC Cheerleader? We can't let this one go.
Oh, boy.
There she is.
Oh, hello.
She looks like the girl from No Doubt, huh? It's kind of a slutty Suicide Girl style cheerleader.
Yeah, I like that outfit for sure.
And it simply says, well, it's got the colors on the stripes on the outfit. That's are the Jamaican flag.
Yeah.
And the letters on the front, made out in those like collegiate letters, are THC.
A little pot leaf.
And a pot leaf on
dormants everywhere.
Yeah, little one in the center, in the front, around the edge of the dress. Pothead.
Oh, boy.
Why do I keep thinking... Like, this is just a guy with a large flower pot on his head.
Yeah.
With your choice of logo on the front to make sure that people know that you are indeed a pothead.
Right.
One that says dank with a pot leaf with droopy eyes.
I hate that word.
One that says Interstate 420, man.
Yeah, man.
Going on a road trip.
Legalize.
One with a, legalize logo there.
Oh, boy.
Pothead part two. Just get some fake pot leaves and make them into a hair, and you'll look like...
A jackass?
Yeah.
Mr. Cabbage Head? What was his name?
Cabbage Head.
Cabbage Head?
Yeah, from Kids in the Hall.
Jesus.
This is what we've been smoking.
Yes, that has been
Hit us
fantastic.
With some strain info.
Yes, we've been smoking that alien cookies strain.
Is that what that was?
Yeah.
What is it? Is it Indica?
It's actually a 50-50. It's hybrid.
50-50.
Yep, right down the middle.
Just like my favorite raffles. I don't know what that means.
I don't either. I just like to laugh. The strain was created, though, through the popular Alien Dog and Girl Scout cookie strains.
Ooh.
Okay.
Yep, but this bud is incredibly rare to find, but totally worth its time because of its flawless combination of its parents' effects. The Alien Cookies High has a happy and relaxing nature, powered by an average THC level of 21% or more that is mild upon first sip, but can prove to be debilitating if you risk any more.
It's got Jesus Christ level?
Yeah, Jesus Christ pose. It hits you first with a happy lift that leaves you in a state of utter peace before catapulting you into a powerful couch lock moment and leaves you sedated, hungry state that leaves you questioning if you should sleep or eat everything in your house. Oh, man. many users report falling asleep as the high builds, especially if the less experienced or took a few tokes. These effects make Alien Cookies ideal for treating conditions such as chronic pain, appetite loss, muscle spasms, insomnia, and chronic stress or anxiety. This bud is surprisingly sweet vanilla flavor, accented by pungent earth with a strong aroma of pungent kush with a sweet hint of vanilla as the nugs are burnt.
I didn't really get a good taste of it, but I've been drinking a lot of coffee.
Yeah, I definitely hit the earthy part. I could taste that. But I don't know about the vanilla part. But yeah, it's definitely a strong piece here. But,
I don't like the shit that makes me want to sleep, necessarily.
Right. You know, maybe at the end of the day when you're trying to go to bed. Yeah.
Well, there's occasionally. occasionally, and it seems like more so lately, mm-hmm. you get those nights where I just can't fall asleep. And then I will take a few tugs just to try and pass out.
Yeah, that always helps. Yeah, this is definitely a good strain. I would try it out again.
And one more time, what was it?
Alien Cookies.
Alien Cookies.
Yep.
And it's like, how do they come up with these weird ass alien cookies? But yeah, when you read about the lineage of
Alien Dog,
I don't know how they come up with that either. But
right.
I know, right?
But they probably came up with that from two other things.
Right.
That was probably like Alien OG and Chem Dog.
Boom. And of course, the Girl Scout cookies is classic strain.
That's right.
Yeah. That's a pure strain there. I mean, as pure as, you know.
And I know that people describe, like, these cookie-type strains, like, they have hints of the flavor of certain cookies, and I never really get that. I just figure, like, it's just a good thing to relate. Like,
yeah.
People like Girl Scout cookies. People like weed.
Exactly.
Right?
It's a perfect combination.
Right?
Right.
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 Right. Magic Beef.
Magic Beef?
It's a new nickname for Mikey B.
Who wants to pick a song?
That's not new.
It's Mikey B's.
Beep boop boop beep boop boop beep boop beep boop
Mikey B, you got a song.
I've had a song.
That one's not new.
I've been wanting to do for track for a minute, and I keep forgetting.
Oh.
Oh, yeah, I love that song.
Yeah, keep that song.
Forgetting, not in love anymore.
I keep forgetting.
Things will never be the same again. No, I don't do no clean versions.
I know what he's going to play.
No, you don't.
There we go.
No, you don't.
Girl, you cut
out. Ooh.
Is that Outkast?
Oh, this seems to be like
Outkast.
The default song in my head when I get high for like the last 3 months for some reason. I don't know why.
Oh, yeah.
Definitely digging the horns.
You know, it has been a minute since I listened to either of these albums, the double albums that came out.
When it came out, I wanted to like Andres more, but I think in the end, Big Boy won.
Right. Big Boy did win.
If you're a fan of hip hop and that's what you think that they did best is hip hop, then yeah, he did have the better. He certainly had the more hip hop album.
Andre got points for creativity.
He took a lot of chances on there.
And Big Boy was like, hey man, Big Boy was not biting the hand that fed him.
Right. But it was kind of brilliant how they handled this, because clearly they were working on stuff separately. They were so prolific in their output that they couldn't just wait until it was just the two of them in the room to start producing music. They were clearly doing stuff on their own. And instead of let that get in their way of like, oh, I want to go this way or that way or do this or that, just go your separate ways and then promote the fuck out of it. I believe there was even some like drama. Maybe it was just speculation. Maybe it was because
people thought they broke up.
Right. I don't know if they actually like did anything to propagate it or if they just were silent about it and everyone was like, oh shit, Outkast broke up and they're both going to come out with like competing albums.
Right.
And then by the time they came out, they were kind of leaning into that. Now everyone understanding that it was really just a joke. There's no bad blood between them, but there was kind of a competition of like, well, whose album are you going to like more and whose album's going to do better and who's going to have the hit that hits the highest. Now, Andres gave us Hey Ya.
It's true. Andres' song will be on the radio forever.
So, there's that.
Yeah.
Like,
I'm saying I didn't like it, but I just said, like,
Roses?
Yeah.
I'm
not saying I didn't like it. I just liked Big Boy's album.
I hear you, though.
Like,
as a whole,
I'd skip around on Andres. Big right. Boy's, I'll tell just you. Push play.
Well, for me, Andres was like, you could put that on in many different situations, including having sex. The Big Boy's album was the one that, like, I don't know, if I really needed to get pumped up. Like, if I was going out somewhere, was excited, or, you know, just was doing some exercise or some work around the house, or, you know, feeling slow or lazy at work. So it's something to get the blood going. Like, he had the energy in that album was just amazing.
Both albums.
Yeah. I mean, at the end of the day, you got a brilliant double album by two creative yes. geniuses.
Right.
Yeah, usually double albums, they're either super awesome or should right. have been one album. This was a double album that the whole thing was good.
Right, this is the type of double album that we got like from the Beatles and the White Album.
Yeah.
Their output was so high, and they didn't even know what to do with all this shit. They're like, fuck it. It all goes on this one album.
See, I'm of the unpopular opinion, and I'm sure I've said it before, that I thought Use Your Illusion could have been one album.
Yes.
Yeah.
There's a lot of people that do that, too. There's been people make a list of, like, I think around the, well, what anniversary would it have been?
For Use Your Illusion?
Yeah. Has it been 20 years?
It's going to be 25 next year.
Yeah.
They came Damn. Out in 92, right? Or was it 91? Because
it was 91.
It was 91. It's 25 years this year.
Yeah, that's oh, right. It was 25 years this year, and people were putting together, like, if you could just have one Use Your Illusion album, what would it be? And they all picked their tracks.
By the way, think about this, because I've thought about this a lot this year. Things that were 25 years old in 1991 came out in 1966.
Man,
just put that. Put that in perspective,
right?
Like Led Zeppelin. Led Zeppelin's first album was only 23 years old,
right?
In 1961.
Because, like when you're younger, and you think of 20 years ago, right?
Things before you happened seems so, before you were born. If things seem so right. ancient.
If you like visualize like a timeline in your brain as a kid. If you took a point that was you here in the present and somebody said, hey, you know, 20 years ago, the Beatles were, you know, the most popular band in the world. And so your mind draws this arc that goes all the way back on this line, all the way back, right? There's a point there, right? And then you go to 20 years in the future, you, and you're looking back at that point, and that arc is so small.
Yeah.
That 20-year arc is so small in your mind compared to what you thought of 20 years ago was as a kid. And it's just the difference between imagining it and living it, I guess.
I guess so, man.
But I think it gets more... It continues to get more compressed. That's the evil part of time.
So many albums turned 25 this year. Never mind. 10.
Right.
Pearl Jam's in for the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame.
Rock and Roll Hall of Fame?
In 20 years, hopefully we're still talking and going, hey, did you know it was like 25 years ago that we started Christopher Media? Oh my God, it seems like yesterday. And that arc in our mind will be so small even compared to that arc between us now and us thinking 20 years in the past from now. I can't even follow my own conversation at this point.
This is a 25-year-old track right now.
I listen to, because they're up for the Hall of Fame. Is this going to be one of those where it's a no-brainer and
should
they
be.
Get in the first year that they're nominated.
They fucking better.
Oh yeah. I think
so. Even though I'm in the club of after their first three, I don't give a shit. Mm-hmm. Like this one versus in Vitology, I'm in. Everything after that, they started getting
the last one was pretty decent.
They started getting preachy. They started like thinking they were punk rock. It's like you're not punk rock. Pearl Jam, knock it off.
Yeah. Right.
But no, yeah, they should fucking get in.
I actually like their last two albums.
You know, speaking of time, I listened to Neil deGrasse Tyson's podcast again today, as I always listen to it when they come out. He had Michio Kaku on there. This is one of the co-creators of string field theory. It's just a theory to unify the physics of the micro universe or the quantum realm, kind of the E equals MC squared for the quantum realm.
This was 25 years old when Even Flow came out.
Right, yeah. No, I know. Doesn't it? Like, just thinking about it in that respect.
Blows my mind! Sorry! Yeah.
No, I hear you. So they're talking about... Well, they were talking about time travel, and they were also talking about teleportation. And it reminded me of... I remember we had a conversation on the Weedsmen about... I think it started with time travel, but Chris, you had started talking about teleportation and how... I think it started with, like, the big three were keeping teleportation technology
big three,
down.
Law enforcement. Right. I got a widespread conspiracy right now. It's big. Oh, big three, law enforcement, big oil.
Right.
All joining together to keep the teleporter down.
That's right.
No, my argument on that was that was so far from feasible and that time travel is actually more likely based on what we know about current physics. What I found out today from Michio Kaku...
What?
A scientist. He's a scientist. He was, again, the co-creator of string field theory, quantum mechanics, theory that unifies quantum mechanics. And he said that the way he described it, talking about it, that basically they already have the ability to teleport atoms, to make them appear where they want to. And... So they,
all right, here's my...
they have teleportation. Oh, wait, let me finish though, real quick. Are they
the same atoms?
Yeah, they have.
So it's not like a reinterpretation of you. So it would be like your atoms. So it would
I guess.
So in theory, it would be you.
Right. Well,
it's not you put back together.
Yeah, I don't know. That's a good question.
Facsimile.
The episode was about time travel, so they didn't go into teleportation, but they talked about teleportation in relevance to time travel. And remember when I was saying that teleportation would be... No, that's right. We were talking about time travel. Talking about time travel would be impossible because where you would appear.
It's about to get towelied.
Right?
Yeah.
No, totally.
Your towel.
I have no idea what's going on. Mm-hmm.
Right, if you traveled back in time even a few minutes, you would be off the planet because the planet travels through space.
Right.
Or you'd just be in a different spot on the planet. No, you're right.
But not only is teleportation... So time travel is possible, according to Michio Kaku, on a larger scale by traveling through the center of a black hole. So you have teleportation... on a miniature scale, and time travel on a larger scale. And I also found out what the TARDIS stands
for.
This
is going to come up at the meeting, by the way.
TARDIS. It's, if I remember correct, time and T-A-R, time and relative distance in space.
Okay.
So it's a trajectorying system to not only move somebody in time, but to keep their relative position in space or relative to whatever. I mean, they could target it. That's why he's able to teleport not only from, you know, one time to another, but to one universe to another.
Crazy.
So not only are they both technologies possible and provable by current understanding of physics, but need to work hand in hand in order for us to... truly utilize these technologies, we will be.
I hope.
Traveling in time and space. I think
that'd
we are.
Be fun.
We are currently traveling in time and space.
Ladies and gentlemen,
be able to
we're floating in space.
That's right.
Manipulate it. That's what I want to do.
All right, let's bring it down to earth for some news real quick before we wrap it up.
Bust it up so there people stop calling us names on the internet. Even though they're not really talking about us, but characters based on us. And at the same time, find my ex-girlfriend who was killed in a car explosion's monkey.
Is this what it sounds like when I talk?
I don't know what the fuck you just said, little kid.
Yeah.
But you're special, man. You reached out and you touched it by the heart.
Yeah. Tracy Morgan with a beard.
I don't know what the fuck.
All right, time for bong hits. I don't fucking remember. I'm high. The news. Do the fucking news.
Ooh, the scary edition.
The scary news. Right. The scariest scary news is one of these two people you've been seeing all over television is going to lead the country.
That's really scary.
For the next 4 years.
Yeah, that's...
That's really scary.
Which, hey,
That's actually me crying.
Good time to promote the Live Unregimented podcast.
Oh, yeah.
Live Unregimented.
Right. Oh, I got everything set up. We got to test it. But,
oh, yeah, right on.
Yeah, it's going to be 9:30 on election night.
We're going to do a live broadcast. We got to...
I might join you because I'm a first-time ever voter. I could be.
You've never voted? You're 30?
No, this is the first time I've
36
voted.
Years
Let's
old?
Do
yeah,
it.
Because voted? I don't give a fuck. I never have given a fuck. And this is the first year where I feel like I should actually
You're
give
like,
a fuck.
Oh, hey. Yeah.
All right, well, here's some issues that you could give a fuck about.
Need to jump in here, maybe.
Yeah.
Put a stop to this.
Yeah, maybe I need to intervene.
Outside of who's going to be president, the other issue at hand in a lot of states is whether they're going to legalize cannabis or not for recreational or medicinal purposes.
Cali, Prop 64. Come on. I mean, I heard it's ahead by like a ridiculous, like 62% are like in favor or something like that.
Yeah, they've been doing a lot to spark the conversation. Is the current campaign that's happening across California. They're touring across California and on a Spark the Conversation bus.
Oh.
There you go.
You know what? I did see in Pacific Ocean, some comments. When I was in Oregon, I did see, because there, you know, not so much Santa on the anti-drug ads, but I did see one that wasn't so much don't do pot as much it was... Pot passes time. I choose to make memories. And it's some chick holding her head out the fucking window in the car. Like, I'm like, oh, I see what you're doing there, Oregon. You're like,
hey. Choose to make memories.
Yeah.
Here's a memory. Go
I thought it was a lame attempt. Yeah, and then the thought I had was like, you know what? If you don't have any memories that start, hey, this one time we were really drunk.
Right.
Or,
right.
Hey, this one time we were really high. I would like to argue that you have not made any memories worth having.
Yes. Right.
You've not been a normal person.
Yeah, I choose to make memories. Yeah, remember that time you were doing keg stands? No, exactly.
Even now, my old ass, well, not old ass, no, sorry, Dad, you listen.
Right.
My older straight-laced parents now, they got their share of stories of like, hey, this one time I was drunk, and like, I just think it's part of being like, you know, a regular human being.
At least part of experiencing
the
world.
One.
Yes.
Yeah, oh, yeah.
Usually all in college, generally.
Hey, but, Squares, expand your mind.
Yeah.
So they're going around. They're getting together with local dispensaries, medicinal dispensaries, and other people that are in the scene, and getting them to talk about their experience with cannabis, why they think it should be legal, why people... for some reason, still are thinking that it's some evil drug.
Are they handing out tacos?
Yeah.
And Doritos?
Yeah.
Hey, but tell me about your experience with cannabis, and they'll give you this taco.
Yeah. Or no, maybe that was in Pittsburgh where they had the
if they're smart, this bus would double as a food truck.
Mascot.
Exactly. I'm just saying.
I bet you there's food trucks there. No mention of food trucks in this report on the Dope magazine. So, yes.
Dope magazine?
Again, the big one to watch is California. As they go, so goes the nation.
Right.
And there is another thing we've been talking about a lot recently, and all the news on cannabis the last week or so has been about polls.
I got a poll for you.
Yeah. National Gallup poll shows 60% of Americans now supporting legal marijuana.
Oh, it's only going to get more as...
as we age, as Gen X gets older, it's only going to get, the number's only going to get bigger.
Right. Up from 2011, it was 58%. So that means that we cycled through 2% of the population
yeah.
in those 5 years.
Oh, boy.
Well, sure, that's bad news for yeah. those of you who love your grandmothers and grandfathers and everything.
Well, since what year was this?
But it's good news for progress.
Yeah. Can't stop progress. There's a Clutch song about it.
Yeah, I know.
I'm going to go around the country speaking at grandparents' funerals yeah, and dude, you should, and what they mean to the cause, the marijuana cause.
You should do children's right. parties.
I know that you're sad for your meemaw's passing, but
hey,
understand.
We can all get high.
Yeah,
but understand that
vote.
This is how a country grows. It has to shed its skin. It has to slough off, the bad cells. Well, now that yeah. really sounds... I didn't mean that your grandma was made of bad cells, just racist and bigoted ones. But, you know, that's...
Wow. Holy
That's
shit.
Excusable because she's old.
Right. For some sure. reason.
Moving on.
All right. Yeah. Ching on with the scary news.
Ooh. Blood. Almost broke.
Well, no, I mean, it's looking positive overall. Water? Is water scary?
It's a spooky sound effects.
If you're scared of having to go to the bathroom, don't listen
is
to
Metallica.
The- Yeah, it is. Sounds like, yeah, they probably lifted it right from this.
Ooh. Oh, well, no. Still, it's bud? Rain. There we go.
Is this Raining Bud by Slayer?
Yeah.
I think this record was probably used for multiple samples. Metal band.
Yeah. Of course.
Raining night in Georgia. Yeah.
In California, there's plenty of people who are still against it for whatever reason.
They avoid here.
Yeah. Yeah. There's a headline that I read.
In San Diego.
A headline on the Press Democrat says, deadly toll from marijuana violence grows in Sebastopol. I guess it's a place. As Californians face vote. So, it's not saying don't vote it down. It's just saying, hey, you know, there's violence around marijuana, you know,
mm-hmm.
which, I mean, okay, so three people were gunned down in rural Sebastopol during a marijuana deal that left two dead and one seriously wounded.
That must be good shit.
That's very unfortunate.
Yeah,
but
super unfortunate.
I understand the way that the headline is written, it's to make you think, well, we should really rethink legalizing cannabis if... You know, there's this type of violence linked to it. Well, it really argues
that's
the other
side. Black market
shit.
Yeah, that goes down
right.
once cannabis is legalized.
What you should be saying is, please vote yes on legalizing cannabis in California
if
so we don't have people shooting each other over cannabis.
Was legal, right. This gentleman would be alive.
Right. There would never be an argument.
And that's what makes it the scary news, because someone thinks, like, you know, the opposite.
Right.
and the sound effects.
This is why facts are useless. You take facts and you interpret them how you like.
That's what Trump does.
There you go.
Trump denies things. There's straight up proof of him saying. Like there'll be video, a tweet.
There's another one in the in Boston. This is an actual advertisement, isn't it? Wait a minute.
I thought that was Mike whispering into the mic again.
It's scary news.
That's right. Scary news.
It's so easy to do. You're rushing and leave something where you shouldn't. That's why in states where pot is legal, vets report increases in accidental pot ingestion. In Colorado,
this is part of the sound effects.
Yeah. Has quadrupled. Pets aren't the only ones at risk. Legalization will expose kids to a drug their developing brains can't handle. Poison Control reported 4,000 children were exposed in 2015. Pot edibles look just like regular snacks. Can you tell the difference?
Yes, I can.
First of all, why did they have the woman in the Windows program narrate their commercial?
Right.
Did that not sound like that was a bot?
Yeah.
That did not sound like a real person.
Right.
Edibles can look just like gummy bears. And I didn't show you the video, but in the video, it shows like a dog getting up on the counter and taking cookies out of an open bag and a little kid coming by and doing the same thing.
Oh.
Right.
Then they're both, somebody's going to have a good time.
The next shot is them both sharing a pair of headphones and listening to Pink Floyd.
Yep.
Dog's got the right headphone on. Kid's got the left headphone on.
Both Chinese. Just
laying on the carpet, staring up at the ceiling.
Is anybody in there?
Yeah.
The idea that we look at anything.
This empty Dorito bag.
Whether anything in anything at all should be illegal or legal based on it, whether it could or could not possibly hurt somebody's kid or dog.
Right.
It's ridiculous. No, nobody's called for a ban on bleach. And I don't see any PSAs telling you to keep it locked up or even not underneath the kitchen sink where everyone keeps it.
Right, yeah.
But, hey, your baby or your dog drinks bleach, what's it going to do? It's going to fucking die.
Right.
Yeah.
Exactly. Right?
If it ingests cannabis, it's going to get really sick.
Pretty much be responsible.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to take that responsibility. They like to blame it on somebody
Like, there's
else.
Nothing in this law that mandates that you must leave the package of marijuana brownies out on the counter in an unzipped up Ziploc bag right. for 24 hours after purchase.
People are idiots.
We understand. We have medication and alcohol and all kinds of drugs, cigarettes, and dangerous items like corrosive liquids and poisons and fucking outlets. Fucking electrical outlets. And lamps. And toasters and radios and all kinds of shit that can kill people.
Yeah.
That's pretty trippy, man. I like the animation. I love it when he starts making up
rounds.
Oh my he claims God, to drugs. Ad-lib all those parts when he's, like, singing along with the song.
Nice. I could go to prison unless I testify against you.
Marge, it's making my eyes better, and it's legal. I could walk up to the president and blow smoke in his stupid monkey face, and he'd just have to wow. sit there grooving on it.
This is great.
Trippy.
Wish like I was wearing VR.
Like that Doctor Strange movie. Everybody's got good reviews on that movie, man.
Oh, yeah. I've been hearing a lot of good stuff.
Hello?
Marge, I just realized I am the owl in the word now. And if you tell anyone...
Minutes ago. Hang on, I'm waiting. Hello?
Hey, it's me. I got Marge in the other line, and she is totally bumming me.
Awesome.
Wow, that saxophone would make a great pipe.
Wow.
Look at Shemp. He is so high.
Hey, Shemp is hemp spelled backwards.
And Otto nice. Is Otto backwards.
Now I'm scared.
That was great.
So out of here. This just in, the Marijuana Recriminalization Initiative took another step forward today as supporters collected the final signatures required to place it on the ballot for next Tuesday's election.
We gotta get out and stop that initiative. Arch, I'm gonna need 10,000 veggie burritos.
No guac in mine.
Good night, Homer.
Dude, your mom is hot.
All right. Oh, that's great.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Turn my headphones up.
Yeah. Turn my headphones up.
Where's my snare?
Yeah.
There's no snare in my headphones.
Yeah. What?
No, really, what?
No, what? Huh? What? No, I can't hear out of this ear.
Turn my headphones up. Yeah,
yeah. Ooh. Wrapping it up.
There we go.
Wrapping.
Thank you for downloading the Weedsmen Podcast for free on iTunes or from ChristopherMedia.net. Please make sure to rate the Weedsmen 5 stars on iTunes, whatever you think we deserve.
Please.
And help to tell others about the Weedsmen by leaving a comment.
Yeah, that's what you gotta do. That's part of how iTunes ranks you. It's not just by the downloads, kiddies.
That's right. Yeah, those comments, they make a big difference.
Yeah.
Thanks for following the Weedsmen Podcast on Twitter.
At the Weedsmen 420.
And on Instagram.
At the Weedsmen Podcast.
Please follow the Weedsmen on Facebook and like and share this show, the Weedsmen Potcast. P-O-T, please.
Yes, with T.
Please visit ChristopherMedia.net for all other podcasts available on the Christopher Media Network. You can check out...
Oh!
Hey, we got Unregimented coming up, a live episode.
Episode of Unregimented on
People We're doing a live election night.
9:30.
You ain't got nothing better to do on election
Eastern
night.
Eastern time, by the way.
Just listen, have fun, listen to these guys. They're good.
Yeah.
That could be a long episode.
I might show up. I don't know.
I mean, it'll be available, you know, the next day, but at the same time, why don't you not listen to it live?
Right.
Who knows if we'll still be making podcasts the next election.
You never know.
You never know.
You should listen.
Yeah. But if you'd like to donate to the Weedsmen Podcast, you can click on the donate button at ChristopherMedia.net. You can use PayPal. Do that. All nice and neat. Nice and neat. Using the internet.
Yeah, I like
to donate money. If you use Amazon.com, please click and bookmark the Amazon link at ChristopherMedia.net. It's not going to cost you any extra money, and you're going to help to support the Weedsmen Podcast.
These are all clickable buttons, people.
Yeah. Like even Amazon, you just got to go through once, bookmark it, and you're done. And then you're going to go to Amazon, get your bookmark.
You make it sound so easy.
You're getting your Amazon. You're helping us out.
Yeah. I like it.
If you're looking to launch your own website, please click through the HostGator banner at ChristopherMedia.net. Christopher Media uses the HostGator banner. Or wait, uses HostGator to host all of the shows produced by Christopher Media Network.
Clicked on a banner.
When you click through the HostGator banner at ChristopherMedia.net and sign up for HostGator, you are helping to support the Weedsmen Podcast.
We all know, bro, that choosing the perfect gift for a man or a bro is a difficult task, but not anymore. The BroBasket.com is here to help. We all know men are hard to shop for, but what do guys actually like? Their favorite alcohol.
And alcohol.
That's what. It could be craft beer, wine, whiskey, scotch, or tequila. The BroBasket.com will put it in a gift basket full of their favorite gear and goodies. You can customize your own Bro Basket or choose from a variety of different Bro Baskets, like the Ultimate Import Sampler, the Jack and Coke gift set, or the Junior Executive gift basket.
Boozeless.
But still cool.
Very cool.
Bro Baskets are also available. The BroBasket.com gives you many shipping options to choose from, including rush delivery and Saturdays.
Hey, 21 and over. Please, state and local laws apply. Beer, liquor, wine are not available for shipping in all states. Bro! Hey. You can also help support Christopher Media by clicking through the BroBasket.com banner at ChristopherMedia.net. Men used to be hard to shop for. BroBasket.com.
Bro!
Bro.
Peace the fuck out, people. Stay high.
Stay high. Stay high, Halloween.
Oh, high Halloween.
Halloween. Oh. Ah!
If you enjoy this show and want more people to know about it, head on over to iTunes, leave a comment, and rate it 5 stars. Make sure you like and share us on Facebook, and don't forget to follow us on Twitter. Just search for Christopher Media. Thank you in advance for supporting Christopher Media by clicking on the PayPal button and by clicking through to all the sponsors who support ChristopherMedia.net. Most importantly, we would like to take the time to extend an extra special thanks to you. Christopher Media could not exist without your support. Thank you for visiting ChristopherMedia.net, and thank you for listening. Christopher Media. Let's make some noise. Thank you for visiting ChristopherMedia.net.
You- You might not think that a few simple words could make you crave McDonald's breakfast sandwiches. But if you listen closely to the sound of me saying McGriddles, McMuffin, you might be wrong. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.